Okay, so today's game is against Gillingham. Look at the weather. It's beautiful. Feeling happy today, we're going to win. There, I've said it. I'm going to even give a prediction. I'm going to give 2-0. Dill, watch your back, mate. Don't want him getting run over. I'm here with Dill. But yeah, it's pretty cold, pretty wet. Hopefully some good tackles flying in. Used to love playing football in this. Anyway, so 2-0 prediction. We've got Josh Morris to score. And I don't care who scores the other. But we're going to win. Simple as that. Feeling positive. Just being dropped some stuff off at the food bank as well. Like I say, if you ever get a chance to take anything to the food bank, take something, whether it's just one can or three bags, whatever, four bags. Just if you can help out, they'd be grateful for it. So yeah, I'll catch you all inside the ground. And hopefully it's a bit drier. Bird just got turned inside out and just put across the face. Luckily, Eaves put it to the wrong side of the post, back post, but it should have been 1-0. But yeah, what can you say? Same old, same old. Okay, so a chance then. Matty Lund straight to keeper. But it's close as we've come. But it's a bit of a scrappy game, nothing game really. We are just watching. Straight at the other end. Gave Eaves into the box and just let him run through two defenders. Same old story. Oh, another chance there for Gillingham. But yeah, we're just standing off people every freaking time. It's doing my head in, honestly. That's a bit of play there by Scunthorpe, but just can't control it. Say Lund had a chance, then spun round, but it just didn't drop quick enough for him. He got his toe end to it. But it's not. There's not much promise in this game. Gillingham have definitely had more better chances. But I'm just watching it and we're just missing a right. We're missing a right back that can get down the wing. Is what we're missing. There's no width. So, but we ain't got the players to do it on the bench. Good chance there. We have 3-on-2. Bad ball by Novak, in fairness. Gillingham got back. Luckily fell back to meet it and Holy got across. It's a big keeper to beat though. So, but yeah, we had another chance there. But yeah, a little mistake there by Gillingham at the back. That's what we need. If I'm being honest, I don't think we're going to unlock him otherwise. They should have scored. Gillingham should have scored. Put into the near post, dummy. Got that, knocked the edge of box. And it's just put it straight over the bar. Actually, being on target, probably in, I'll be honest. It's probably the easiest chance anyone's had this half. But yeah, I feel once again like it's just a matter of time before we score. It's just no organisation in the back. We just, I don't know, slow. Graham Salisbury does not have a clue. He's just gone to book Burgess for a tackle after about 2 minutes beforehand. It wasn't Burgess, so he's booked Good instead. But he doesn't have a clue who he's doing, or what he's doing even. It's just... It doesn't... Oh, like, it's bad enough anyway watching us play, but when we've got a referee like that, it just exasperates things. Okay, so we've got a free kick. Wharton's just been brought down. We're about 35 yards out. And once again, Thomas took it. Absolute garbage. Same as at Shrewsbury. Unbelievable. Oh, chance there. Birch, edge of box, just over the bar. Just over the bar. Morris ran into the box to get the ball. And possibly he took a touch. Might have been, apparently, but since he's not got two free kicks, definite free kicks, he probably would have got nothing. Probably got booked for simulation. But yeah, a chance right at the end of the first half. Go on. Angle of that made it look like it was more likely to go in than it actually was. But Perch, effort there at the end. That's it for the first half. Time assessment. Get me to them biscuits. Okay, so being in, got some biscuits. That's what all the fuss is about. Fruit shortcake. But there are, there were other biscuits, but yeah, that's it. That's what the fuss was about in the lounge. And yeah, biscuits are back. Okay, so first half, 0-0. Not been the greatest of halves from a Scunthorpe perspective. A couple of chances, but I mean, there's no width down the right hand side. McArdle making the odd run down there, but it's not enough. Say Jordan Clark will be down there all the time and tracking back. I know McArdle's a different type of player, but it's not providing that win for us. So, but Gillingham had the better chances. Gillingham should probably be 1-0. But yeah, it's just, you know, will I take 0-0 right now? Yeah. Do I think it'll be 0-0 at the end of the game? No. So, all we can do is keep doing what we're doing and not concede, basically. If we score, we score. I'll be happy if we score. Well, I predict a 2-0. I can't see us scoring two goals at all. So, yeah. Second half, here we come. Let's hope it's better than the first. Okay, so this is going to hear from the crowd. Just not happy. So Graham Salisbury ruining the game of football again. More so than Scunthorpe are. Which takes some doing right now. But yeah, what can you do? Well, there's a cracking turn and shot in the first place. Came off the post, back out, and Scunthorpe just stand and watch. And then Dan Eaves has just picked the ball up, turned, put it in the bottom corner. It's been coming. We're absolutely crap, as we have been all season. There's no, well, it is consistently crap. But, yeah, they just don't have any idea at all. And if anyone tells me they do have an idea, please tell me what the idea is, because I'm yet to see what it is. Honestly. They're just shambles. I can't wait for Doncaster next week, because we're going to get smashed. Wow. Josh Morris straight to the other end. Just over the bar. Just over the bar. And there's number two. Once again, player stood. No one around him. Inside edge of box, all the time in the world, picky spot to put it in top corner. Okay, Gillingham's running right now. Eaves again, put it across goal, just missed the post. It's just, you don't want to, well, you don't know what to say. It's not being said before. Well, I've got 30 more minutes of watching this garbage. Okay, so Stuart McCall's just got booed there for bringing Matty Lund off, which crowd weren't happy with. But, let me say, for me, it could take all 11 off. Okay, so penalty now to Gillingham. It just gets better and better. But at least we've got biscuits back. So thank you to the sponsors for those. Yeah, just heard Donny are winning 4-0 as well. So bring on the keep mode. Okay, so Tom Eaves. I think I said Dan earlier. Definitely Tom Eaves. He's taking his penalty.
That's a 3-0.
Going for top right here. Or is it going to get saved? Oh! Wow. Put it straight over the bar. That was shocking. Absolutely shocking. Look how nice he's done that. I'd like to say that would be a lifeline for us, but definitely not. Okay, so we've got a free kick now. Not a lot has happened in this half for us, I'll be honest. He's trying to keep his arms. He's not getting a flick on or anything. He's just soul destroying being a Scunthorpe fan right now. But take the rough with the smooth, don't you? I've definitely got it rough, but with the last few seasons it's definitely been smooth. Like, it's not depressing enough. We've just got 4 minutes of added time. Oh, thank you. Christmas has come early. But yeah, I've got a corner. Let's just stick with this. Something to do. And it came to nothing. So about a minute left. If that, we just got a corner. The ball, but it's on the line, and we still can't turn it in. It's all over. It was all over half an hour ago. That's it, whistle's gone. And the boos ring out. Merry Christmas. That's just not good enough. At all. It's not good enough. Okay, so for anyone wondering, I have managed to find some highlights from the game today. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's about as good as it gets.